Uruguay nomás. Hola a todos y bienvenidos a mi canal. If this is your first time here, mi nombre es Victoria y esto es The Spanish Express. I am wearing my Uruguay football t-shirt today because we're going to talk about football. As you may already know, Uruguayans are passionate about this sport. It's part of our national identity, and that's why we have many idiomatic expressions related to football that I'm about to share with you. Los de afuera son de palo. This expression goes back to the 16th of July of 1950 and has Obdulio Varela as its protagonist. Obdulio Varela was the team captain of the Uruguayan football team at that time. Uruguay was playing the finals against Brazil in the Maracanã Stadium in Rio de Janeiro. All the odds were against Uruguay because a tie was enough for the Brazilian team to become the new champions. The celebrations for the Brazilian victory were already planned, the front pages of the newspapers were already printed, and the government even had minted commemorative coins with the names of the Brazilian football players. Before going into the field, the Uruguayan Football Association directive told the players that getting into the finals was already an accomplishment and that they should avoid the Brazilian team scoring them 6 goals. The thing is that Obdulio Varela wasn't very happy about playing a defensive game, and that's when he said this phrase to all the other team players to encourage them. Los de afuera son de palo could be translated as outsiders are made of sticks or outsiders are made of wood. The meaning of this phrase is that you don't have to pay attention to people on the outside because they are not inside the game, they are not playing it, so their opinions don't mind. You just need to focus and do your thing. And that's exactly what Uruguay did. During the second half and after 2 minutes, Brazil scored a goal, but Uruguay reverted the result and ended up winning with 2 goals, one of José Schiaffino and the other one of Alcides Guidia. The whole stadium went silent. There were only the cheers of the Uruguayan team. Even the president of the FIFA had a moment of hesitation before giving the cup to Obdulio. This game is known as Maracanazo and is considered the greatest feat in football history. So now you know, the next time you're ashamed of speaking a foreign language because of your accent, or you're just afraid of failing, remember, los de afuera son de palo. Vayan pelando las chauchas. If you have been studying Spanish for a while, you may already know that some fruits and vegetables change their names on different countries. Chauchas or judías verdes, alubias, habichuelas is what we call green beans in Uruguay. But what does it have to do with football? Well, it is said that when football was amateur in Uruguay, the tradition was to eat an asado after each game. Asado is one of our national dishes. The losing team had to peel the chauchas to make the salad. So basically, vayan pelando las chauchas means you are on the losing team, that you lost a match. We even have a song called Vayan pelando las chauchas that we play when there's a Uruguayan football match. Vayan pelando las chauchas, vayan pelando las chauchas, aunque les cueste trabajo. La garra charrúa. Before I explain to you what la garra charrúa means, there's another expression you need to know first, tener garra. This literally translates as having claw, which in Spanish means to be fierce and brave. We could better translate this to English as having guts. When people talk about the Uruguayan football team, they often mention la garra charrúa, or in English, the claw of the charrúa. The charrúas were the people that inhabited our land before the arrival of the Spanish conquerors. And even though they didn't stand a chance against them, history says that they fought with tenacity and courage. Uruguayans embrace the characteristics of the charrúas because we fight until the very end. Even if something seems impossible, we're going to give everything we have. And that's la garra charrúa, is facing adversity, is believing in the impossible and never giving up. If you have seen our national team playing, that's our spirit. Pizarrear, o ser un pizarrero. I really like this one. Pizarrear comes from the noun pizarra, or in English, scoreboard. Pizarrear means to play real good and show off when the result shown in the pizarra is good, when you're winning. Pizarreros regularly make things they wouldn't do on a match if they were losing, like scoring a hat-trick or un gol de chilena. Sometimes we even use this expression to talk about football fans. For example, fans that go to every match if their team is winning, but the moment things turn the other way, they just disappear. Other countries like Colombia also have the word pizarrero, but it has a completely different meaning because their pizarrero comes from Francisco Pizarro, the Spanish conqueror, and they use it to talk about a treacherous person. Uruguay no más! This is a very difficult one because, to be honest with you, I have no idea how to translate it. Uruguay no más is something we shout when Uruguay scores a goal, and in everyday life, we use it when something really good happens. For example, you like this video and subscribe to my channel, and I'm going to shout Uruguay no más. It's also used, ironically, when something happens that makes most Uruguayans ashamed. Ponerse la camiseta o ponerse la celeste. Esto es una camiseta de fútbol. Ponerse la camiseta means to be a part of a team, to be a good team player, to contribute to a greater cause. Nowadays, this expression is mostly used by businesses and companies to exploit, to encourage their employees to work harder for the greater good. This expression comes from the football world because to be a part of a team, you need to wear its uniform. This expression is not exclusive from Uruguay, and that's why we have our very own version, ponerse la celeste, because that's how we called our t-shirt and our national team. Sudar la camiseta. Sudar la camiseta means to sweat the shirt, and it means to make a great effort to accomplish something. When football players are giving it all, they sweat their shirts, and that's the origin of this expression. Cortita y al pie. In football, a short pass direct to the foot. In everyday speech, concise, straight to the point. Like this explanation. Estás en la B. This one is not exclusive to Uruguay. I know at least Argentinians use it as well. If a Uruguayan tells you estás en la B, it means you're in a very bad position in some aspect of your life. In some countries, the first division and the second division are called A and B respectively. I know it sounds a little dramatic, but for Uruguayans descending from the first division to the B division is a tragedy. El día del golero. In Uruguay, we have days for everything. Father's Day, Mother's Day, Children's Day, Grandparents' Day, but we don't have a goalkeeper's day. When someone says something is going to happen, el día del golero, is because it's never going to happen. We have plenty of expressions that come from the football world in Uruguay, and this is just a small selection I did. If you like this video, I can make another one in the future and show you some more. I would like to know, do you have any expressions in your language that come from the football world or any other sport? Please let me know in the comment section down below. Muchas gracias, thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe to my channel and follow me on social media for more content in Spanish. Hasta la próxima, chao chao!